Angel. I'm here in Backville, the office, the warehouse, shop. And I'm going to start working on the compressors now. Cause I got like 8 of them. You know, they need to be, you know, get ready for the summer. I got this model right here, that Rol-Air. It's a 160GX. I'm going to be working on it. Right now, just like put a little bit of a degreaser so I can clean it up. You know, it's kind of messy, but we'll just get there, you know, eventually. Just gotta clean it up first. So I like to work on this clean equipment and deliver it in the same shape, okay, clean. So I guess this one's missing the pulley, and also I'm gonna do the oil change on it for the engine and the compressor head. I got some oil over here that I got for this purpose. So stay tuned and I'll show you how to do all these maintenance on these compressors. All right, stay tuned. All right, everybody, so working on cleaning this compressor. So I want it to be really nice, you know? I like to deliver clean equipment once it's fixed. So I'm just gonna work on the cleaning of this compressor. And then we'll continue to do the maintenance on it. This one's not too beat up. Some of the compressors, they bring them in, and the gas tank smashed. Of the ribs, of the head, you know, which cools the head. Sometimes, you know, 2x4s land on top, so they break them. Just a little careless, you know, with the equipment, but I'm gonna do all the repairs that I need, all right? So we want to start doing this, removing the feet, you know, so we can get some new feet on our equipment, because it's very important. When the compressor is out there, if it's wobbling, you know, can damage the equipment. All right, so we're going to start by replacing the feet. First, we gotta drill the holes a little bigger because these holes are kind of small, so we can attach the new feet, all right? Next, we're gonna replace our pulley. missing. Very simple step. There you go, and it's off. A brand new one. Later on we'll come back and redo this one, you know. I got the actual handle for it. So but right now just gonna slap a new one. It's not the original obviously, but it doesn't matter. It works. Oops, wrong hole. Alright, so I got the compressor running. I'm gonna let it run for a little while in order for the oil to get hot and the hydraulic oil to get hot too, so I can do the oil change. Apparently this is way low. Everything set up and ready to drain the oil out of our compressor. First of all, I'm going to be removing the stick that measures the oil so the air can flow through it. Secondly, I'm going to remove the nut that holds the oil inside our little engine. As you can see, there's a hole right here in this roller. That hole is meant for it to the oil, so the oil can drain out of this compressor head. Out of this little Honda engine. This is very useful because I have worked on other compressors that don't have it, and it's kind of a hustle, you know, trying to get the oil out. All right. Next step, I'm gonna remove this other nut from the compressor head so I can drain the hydraulic fluid, the compressor oil. I have latched this cone right here, that way it just runs straight down to my oil pan. It's a 10 millimeter. There we go. There it is. Obviously you're gonna have a little bit of spillage, so have some rags or some towels ready, you know, so you can catch any excess running through it. Alright, so let's continue with this. First of all, I'm gonna put the oil back into the compressor head. Just gotta tie this down. Right. Secondly, gotta remove. Through. This is actually our breather. The head breathes. You know, the inside of the head breathes through this spot. This is what we got. You know, it's a Rol-Air synthetic blend, all weather. So when we're filling this up, we want to make sure, you know, our oil doesn't go over, you know, fill it all the way up. We don't want that, because if it fills all the way up, that means it has too much oil in it. These were not full, by the way. That one was it. This one is. So it's brand new. We pour it and then we wait. By the time it travels all the way down and it fills up, you know, we just gotta wait a little bit so we can see. Like I said, we don't wanna go over, you know, like the bubble all the way up. We don't wanna fill it up. There we go. That's it. That's all we need. All right. Replace. Just hand tight. You don't want it too tight. That should do it. All right. Now let's move forward and do work on our engine now. All right. So I previously removed the stick from this side, and the other cap was on the other side. But this time we're gonna flip it because we wanna make sure, you know, we can check our oil regularly. At least we do. So instead of putting the sticks, a cap on this side, I'm gonna do it and put it on the other side. But right now, I'm gonna put the nut back. Put the bolt back. It's kind of tight, tiny. All right, put the black one right here on the side, the inside, the engine. And for this little engine, we're gonna use a high mileage Pennzoil 10W30, 10 weight 30. All right, so follow me. All right. excess of oil I might have, you know. Okay. You don't want to overfill it, because if you overfill it, these little engines have a sensor, and on the inside, if you overfill it, it won't start. Same if you underfill it, it won't start. Okay, so you gotta be pretty accurate. And the way to tell is the oil has to be like around this level. You know, you don't want it to be pouring out, but you don't want it to be too low, like down here. You want it to be like actually like right around the edge. Check, make sure you got the right amount. Let's see, a little bit more. Let's see if that should do it. But I'm gonna use the stick now, check. Looks like it's right here, so I'm gonna put a little bit more. Yeah, right here. Perfect. This right here. Right. We're gonna remove the outer part. See, like so. And I'm gonna blow it. We'll be right back. the 0.03. So I start from the bottom, work my way up. There is a 3. Okay, we're good. Put it back. I don't have any new ones, otherwise I'll put a brand new one. Filter, the compressor head. It's dirty, you can tell. So we're gonna blow the air from the inside out, okay? Right, we're gonna test it now.